All right, so Xbox has been dominating the news cycle this week. They've had everything from pre-orders to purchasing Bethesda or ZeniMax Media, rather, launching the Xbox beta app, which we're going to take a talk about in this video. Also, xCloud went live if you have Game Pass Ultimate, and we're going to take a look at all this stuff, but probably just in a series of videos. But for this one, we're going to stick to the new Xbox beta app, which is available on Android. Sorry, iPhone users, at the time of this recording, it's only on Android. So again, this is a beta, and you can go to the Google Play Store and download it yourself and give your feedback. I'm also interested in what you think. So make sure to voice that down in the comments below, and I'll take a look at them. And let's bring it up here and take a look. Okay, so I got my phone here. You can see that I have it over here to my right. We're going to take a look at the apps here now. This is definitely a lot snappier, but we'll get to each of these tabs and we'll talk about this. So running across the bottom here, practice that, you can see the five different sections of the app, and you have you have the notification bell in the upper right hand corner here. So if I click on that, you can see like who followed you, invite you to a party, stuff like that. So now you'll be able to notice that the synchronization of these notifications is across all of your devices, like your, you know, the app on the PC or your Xbox or the phone here. And it's really nice because you can check them in one place and they clear on the other devices, which makes it, to me, just a little bit more easy to manage. Okay, so this that you're looking at right now, this is the home page, and this is what you will see when you open the app by default. So we'll go over this in just a second, but just to go across the bottom here, you can see that to the right of that are your messages and your friends. This is called the social tab. And then of course, we all know the magnifying glass. When we see that, means a search. And so if we just go down a little bit further, we have the library tab. And then of course, all the way to the right is your own profile, which gives you some control over that as well. And we'll take a look at each one of these. But we'll start here on the home tab. The first thing obviously you see is the Binding of Isaac, because I've been playing that and I'm a little bit addicted at the moment. I do stream it on Twitch, twitch.tv/AKAScratch. If you want to check that out, that would be super cool. But anyways, I digress. So anyways, a little further down, we have active friends. There's a shortcut to see all of them, which basically takes you to the social tab. I have this section of jump back in where I can manage some of the games listed here. And this is also a shortcut like to the store, and you can install it on your consoles. And then below that are basically just like Xbox Game Pass recommendations, what's popular, and all that kind of stuff are here on the home screen. It's basically just kind of a landing page. Maybe some of it will change, I guess, but I kind of expect to maybe see a little bit more of like a summary or something, like maybe something, shortcuts to popular actions I do or stuff like that. I'm not sure, but this is what's here now and it is useful. So let's just jump over and take a look at the social tab next. Click that. Okay, so this is the social tab. So currently here, we have our friends. We have our messages, and we can create a new message. We can create a party and things like that. And then, for example, if I click on someone here, you can see that it comes up with their highlights. If I scroll just down here a little bit, I can send them a message. There's a button for that. I can take a look, click about and take a look at their profile info. I can see what they've been playing. And then I have other options. If I click the ellipses here, I can invite to a party, for example. And I can just do that right from here. And there's, you know, just a lot of different options. You can kind of manage your friends. It just sort of takes you directly to them. So like I mentioned a second ago, if we come back out here to this tab, up here we have the chats. If I click on them, you can see they actually loaded for me quite quickly. This is not something that happened before for me, which I was pretty excited. I noticed that the requests that come in are missing, but this is a beta. So I expect that that will be added in a future update, hopefully. For now, I'm just simply happy to have functioning messages that load and work on my phone app, because that was not previously the case, as I mentioned. So that's really good. I just have too many. I never check them. Like, I check them, but they go up. So up here, of course, we have the headset with the chat mic, and we can click on that here. I'll show you to start a party. The first thing I'm going to do, I have options between voice and text. If I want to do that, I can add people from the bottom and search for them and click their names. If I click these vertical ellipses here, I'm going to make the party invite only first before somebody jumps in. But I also have other options here, you know, to mute it, make it joinable, and that sort of stuff there. So it's pretty good. And I mostly use the party on the PC now, but you know, this is nice to have if I'm out and about, especially if I'm just, I'm still in the party. You can see it says it's green there, so I just gotta leave. So now I'm out of it. So it's just kind of nice to have it there so that, you know, if I'm out and about and I wanna jump in a party with friends and let them know I'm gonna be late or something, it does make it easy on the phone, especially, works pretty nice actually. Okay, who knows what the next one is? Yeah, that's right, we'll click on it. The next tab, the middle tab, which is the magnifying glass. And like I said, I'm sure most of you know that this is the search function. And you can type here in the search, I'm just gonna put Halo, I guess, just to have it up here, and we'll say done. And then we can look with that. And you can look for people and games. That's the top one. It basically just takes the top of both people and games and includes the top choices of that search by showing them together. But additionally, you can click on people right there, or the games, and get those on like a broader scale. You just have some additional options that you get from other tabs when you click on them, but it's pretty simple stuff. I think we can probably just jump over to the library. So under the library tab currently, we'll go here now. We have captures and consoles up at the top. We'll start with captures first, so I'm just gonna click on that. I kinda hate this Note 8, like if I grip it and I'm touching part of the screen at the bottom, when I try to click, it doesn't do it. I have to like kinda let go of my grip. I hate that curved edge on these phones, but it is what it is. Anyways, all that aside, captures is pretty straightforward. You can see here that I have my captures that have been uploaded to Xbox Live. If I'm playing a game or something and I capture something, whether it's a 30 seconds of video or a screenshot, if it uploads to Xbox Live based on my settings, I'll get a notification on my phone letting me know that it's ready, and I can click on it, and I'm given these options to share, to save it directly to my phone. You can see the save button there. And then if I click the share button here at the bottom, bring that up, you know, you have your Xbox, which gives me access to my activity feed. I can send a message to a friend, and I can select from them below. And then also, if I click these ellipses here, it brings up personal information, so I'm not going to do it. But if I click these ellipses here, it's going to download the file to your phone, and then you're given options to share it, whether it's to Dropbox or an email message or OneDrive or Twitter, or basically any app that is capable of sharing media that's on your phone. You'll see those options there. It's pretty similar to how you've, you know, done it before with other apps. So let's just go back out here. Now in this tab right next to that, we have consoles. So let's click on that and see what we have. This will show you my consoles, and I can connect to them for remote play. So I'm scrolling through. I have, you know, all of the three I have on here now that are listed are the ones that I use the most now, and I can connect to them for remote play. So Xbox remote play is something that we'll go over in another video, but I just wanted to kind of cover it here just to show, if you wanted to try this out, this is where you can do it. So I can pick one of these. I can also manage them. So you can see I've clicked on manage here, which means I can look and see what's installed, and I can clear space. For example, if I do this, it has uninstall there, just to make sure, you know, something's downloaded or the size or whatever the case may be. I can also turn it on as well. When I hit connect, it'll turn on, which is nice. So moving on to the next one. Now this is huge, so I hope you're sitting down. Like, this is something that I wanted so much, is improvement in this remote. And I think they pretty well nailed it here, or at least the direction they're going. So when I click on this little remote icon, okay, it brings me to the back to the last console that I was connected to. So if you have multiple consoles, you're gonna follow what I'm saying here, but I have options to connect to another console if I wanted to do that, and I can see I have them listed here. If I click the ellipses, I can hit switch consoles. They're listed here, and I could switch, and it lets me know the current state of them. Like for example, my Gears is standby, the Studio 2 is standby, and what have you, because it's not currently on. But I have the option down here at the bottom to turn it on the console if I wanted to do that. And having this level of granularity to know exactly which one I'm controlling and to be able to swap back and forth between them is a much better experience than it previously was. It's really nice. Like this whole turn on the console button just right on the bottom, like it works good. So, and finally for this tab, we have a setup new console. I purposely left this for last. This is going to be super useful when you get your new Xbox, whether it's a Series S or an X. To be able to just come here and, you know, you click on it, enter the code on your TV. While everything is doing updates and all the sorts of day one things that you see them do, this kind of allows you to speed that process along. Plus, you don't have to try to type anything on the video game keyboard with the controller, and it'll make it a lot easier. But we'll go over that in another video too, probably when I set up my Series X, to be honest. We'll just do it right then. That'll be a good time to show that off because it'll be topical at the time. But just know that it's there, and it's super useful, and it's going to be super useful when you get a new console. So moving on, so we'll click on the profile. I somehow went back to the main page, but you can see it takes me directly to my highlights. This is similar to what it looked like when I clicked on my friends. Right below my picture is my gamer tag and what I'm doing. So I'm on the Xbox app here. And then there's an option to change your online status. So I'm appearing online, or I can appear offline, however you want to do it. And it also synchronizes to the status of your Xbox. So that was pretty nice. So when you sign in, it just keeps the status. Below we have, as I mentioned, the highlights. They're not really highlights. I didn't really do that good in Overwatch. I just recorded something. And then we also have the About, where I can basically go and see what I have recently been playing if I forget, maybe, or if I, you know, want to install those to another console or whatever the case may be. Kind of just, it's just there to know, I guess. Kind of, you know, so you have it. It's basically kind of the same link you saw on my homepage, and I can click on them and manage to download whatever. So below that we have my bio. And we have my friends, followers, gamer score, location. I did notice that the badges were missing, but again, this is a beta, as I've said twice, I think, at this point. So some of this stuff will probably change before it actually comes out. And so we'll go back up here. And finally, at the top, you can click the cog icon here for some of your profile settings, which basically take you into the personal settings of your profile that you find on other Microsoft websites and apps. Okay, so overall, I think this is a huge improvement to the one that I was using on my iPhone and Android here previously. This one is a lot faster. It has a lot more links to do things that seem natural for the tasks that you would want to complete while you're away from your Xbox. You know, and you hear about a new game drop or something and it gets announced for Game Pass, you want to make sure it's available when you get home. This app makes it pretty easy to do that. And of course, being able to use the remote play on your console with a controller such as this one I have right here. Took a second. But the Razer Kishi, it's really appealing to me. And it should be no problem keeping up with like achievement streaks, doing dailies on some of your favorite games, or just hopping on for a quick session. It's all pretty good. I think there's stuff from the other app that I would like to kind of see, you know, come here. We're still missing sort of like clubs and, you know, the LFG sorts of things. You know, there's a lot of that stuff that's missing, but I imagine it'll make its way over eventually. I think this is a really, really good foundation to start with, at least anyways. So that's going to do it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you go and download this and leave your comments and everything down below. I'm curious to know what you all think. As I said earlier, I know there's some stuff missing, but I do trust that it will be added in the future. I just still, I'll just still submit that for feedback, and some of it just seems it's maybe just still coming. As an early look at the beta, I think it's pretty solid foundation to be building off of, and I'm super excited for the next generation of how this app will keep everything connected together, because my phone is my lifeblood, as I'm sure it is to all of you as well. You know, so it's nice to see the integration between all of your devices kind of being paid attention to here. So that's going to do it for me. We'll wrap this up. Thank you all for watching. I appreciate your support. I can't thank you all enough. I'll catch you all in the next video, or Twitch or Twitter, wherever. Keep being awesome. Be excellent to each other. And I'll see you next time.